As we briefly touched upon a moment ago, asbestos is a naturally occurring fibrous mineral, and there's plenty of it. It can be found in up to 2/3 of the Earth's crust. For many years, it was used in around 3,000 different building and manufacturing products. It's also been used as a form of insulation, for corrosion protection, for fire protection, and even soundproofing for its ability to absorb sound. Asbestos is water resistant, heat resistant, and non-flammable. It's chemically inert, meaning it doesn't react with chemicals. It's strong. When it's tense, asbestos can be stronger than steel. It's flexible. It can be spun and woven like cotton. And it's resilient. It can survive for years. Asbestos has no smell and no threatening appearance. And if it's left untouched, it isn't hazardous. But when it's handled, broken down, drilled, or cut in any way, it can release tiny fibres into the air. And that's when it becomes a risk to health. When they're breathed in, most of these fibres will stick to the mucous membranes in the nose and throat, and they will naturally work their way out. But some fibres will make it all the way into someone's lungs, where their shape and resistance to chemical reaction makes them almost impossible for the human body to get rid of. These fibres can cause serious illnesses and fatalities anywhere between 10 and 50 years after they've made it into the lungs.